So the tropics are famous for their diversity, and the diversity has been measured here. So tell us about the diversity that you get here.
Okay, the 25 hectare here has 160 species. You know, the question fascinates me is, where do species come from? Even though when you look at the forest, you don't really see much change, but as a matter of fact, it changed dramatically. As we can see, there are logs, you know, tree logs on the ground, and also there are a lot of seedlings germinating, you know, from the seeds on a daily basis. So the forest really changed a lot on a daily basis.
So we have 150 species, and to my eye as an ignorant non-botanist, they kind of look much the same. So, and there can be 1,100 species in the Amazon. So how do all of these species persist? So tell us the answer, Nathan.
Well, certainly if there was an easy answer to this question, it would take, we would be quite famous already. But it's wonderful to think about the diversity that is in forests like this. And one of the things that we often think about is, are there differences in the strategy of species? Are they occupying different niches or preferring different environments? Or perhaps other sorts of stochastic or random processes are really important in shaping that diversity. And that's part of what we're very interested in trying to understand.
So I guess what we're saying is that part of it's due to different species having different requirements on a large scale or very much localized. It's about the dynamics. So when gaps are opened, which species come in, how do they survive? It's about competition. It's about the relation to predators, relation to seed predators, to pathogens. Any other thoughts?
Yeah, the pathogens certainly play a very important role here. We do see host specific, like soil pathogenic fungi and also mycorrhizal fungi.
So how are we going to find the answer?
We need more scientists to work on these questions and think about new ways that we can get at some of these processes. There's these wonderful plots that have been established all over the world, great scientists working on them, but many of us sort of feel we need more information and more data, more people thinking about these important questions.